Tell me, I also hear about a concept called privacy by default, or privacy by design, is a fundamental component of the reforms. Perhaps you could talk me through the implications of that for businesses and the issues they need to address and how they indeed support that privacy by design.
Yeah, you're certainly spot on. One of the key changes is now the idea that privacy and data protection is not something that can be put in as an afterthought anymore. The expectation, and in fact it's being regulated as an expectation, is that compliance is being built in as early as possible into each of these processes to ensure that data protection is met at every stage of a product, a process, a data flow, or how an organization conducts business. Now, the main ways that this is going to be done is the concept of privacy impact assessments. Now, what a privacy impact assessment is a structured approach to defining and looking at the data that's involved in any of your projects or processes in such a way as to put you in position to plan for and ensure that privacy and data protection requirements are baked into your cake and are a fundamental part of how business is done.
So, privacy impact assessments, perhaps you could talk me through the implications of those, and indeed, on a practical level, how do customers and businesses go about completing a privacy impact assessment?
Well, privacy impact assessments, while they're a relatively new concept, are very much based around integration with existing processes inside an organization. So the most common way you'll see it implemented these days is as a gateway inside a project management or a risk management process. So at the outset of any kind of big project or, you know, reassessment of what an organization is doing, there may in fact be a gateway built in that allows you to take a structured approach to asking questions about how data will be managed and approached in the project. And by following a structured approach like that, you can identify exactly what the privacy requirements are going to be. Now, this is something that should be done at the earliest stages of a project or as an output from a risk management process. So the aim of the game will be you identify the types of data that are involved in the project, what exactly how the data is composed, who owns the data, where will the data sit, where does the data move to, who are the business owners, the technical owners, and so on. So having a structured perspective approach of how to look at that will put you in a position to identify the risks to that data. Now, the reason you identify your risks is, of course, to engage in the risk management process. You identify your risks, and then you're equally in a position to structurally build out what you can do to minimize that risk. What a privacy impact assessment is about at the end of the day is minimizing the privacy risk to an organization, now, whether it's compliance risk, whether it's security risk, whether it's reputational risk. It doesn't matter, you're all about minimizing that. You're doing it in such a way you've identified your risks, you identify how you're going to address those risks to minimize them, and then you build that back into your project management or risk management processes, which are possibly pre-existing, in such a structured way as to ensure all those risks are addressed and the concerns of an organisation are having met.
Okay, there's a lot for businesses to be thinking about. Thank you very much, Gavin.
You're welcome.